Hi, and welcome to this Tech Insights video. My name is Mary, and I'm an application engineer here at IFM Effector. You are here because you have either purchased or plan to purchase one of our LI series level sensors. In today's video, we are going to go over the programming setup of our LI series level sensors. So let's get started. So here you have the Learn More section on our website for our LI series level sensors. In this video, we are going over the programming setup of these sensors. Out of the box, these sensors come calibrated for water-based media, and the following chart will help you determine whether or not you need to adjust the sensor for your specific media. In this video, I'm going to show you how to manually adjust the sensor using the inductive teach button on the housing of the sensor. These following guidelines include the steps that need to be taken in order to adjust your sensor for these different media types. At the bottom of this page, we also give you examples of what the inductive teach button looks like on the housing of the sensor, as well as what the LEDs look like. And finally, we have a chart that describes what the different LED statuses mean. So now let me take you to the sensor itself and show you how to manually adjust it using the inductive teach button. So in this video, I am going to be using an LI5131 to show you how to manually adjust it using the inductive teach button. Here we have the inductive teach button, as well as the green power LED. This specific part number has 131 millimeter probe length, and at the end, you can see the 28 millimeter active zone. As always, we have other options available with different probe lengths. Below, I have a glass of water to show you how this sensor comes factory calibrated for water-based media out of the box. Here I have vegetable oil and an empty glass, so I can show you how to perform an empty teach to calibrate the sensor for oil-based media. So to begin, I'm going to put the sensor into the glass water. As you can see, the status LED still does not change because the glass is not grounded to earth. As soon as I touch the glass and ground it, you can see the yellow status LED change. Next, if I put it into the vegetable oil glass, even if I ground it, you can see that the status LED still does not change because the sensor is not calibrated for oil. So to begin, I'm going to put the sensor into the empty glass to perform an empty teach. You need a metal object in order to do this, so I'm going to be using a screwdriver. To begin, you need to put the sensor into the programming mode, and you do this by holding a metal object to the inductive teach button for at least 10 seconds. And you will confirm that you are in the programming mode by the green LED flashing twice. So to begin, I will hold the metal object. So now it is in the programming mode, and you can confirm this when the green LED is continuously lit after taking the metal object away. So now to teach it the empty state condition, you will put your metal object back on the inductive teach button, and the yellow LED should begin to flash quickly. Once I take it away, the teach will be confirmed by the green LED flashing twice. So now when I put the sensor into the vegetable oil, you will now see the status LED change. So there you have it. That concludes this Tech Insights video on the programming setup of our LI series level sensors. As always, you can check out our Learn More section on our website for helpful information on any of our products. Feel free to contact us at our service center at 1-800-441-8246 to speak with somebody who can assist you. Thank you for your time and have a great day.